Foiling is such a cool technique and the results are amazing, but the thing with foil is those leftover bits with lots of pretty foil still on it. What to do with them? Now, obviously you can't throw them away, duh. Now don't tell me you just cleaned up and got rid of them.
Oh no!
I'm going to show you a bunch of ways to use the foil scraps to get the most out of those fancy foils. To add those leftover scraps, we are going to need something sticky, and I'm going to start with glue dots. And I have two different size dots, and the first one are on the side of the roll, so I need to press down that roll on my card, which makes that I can't really see what I'm doing. So this is going to be a bit of a surprise. I also tried peeling off the dots, which doesn't really work because it gets more of an X shape than a dot of a circle shape. But if you're going for the X shape, then you can do that as well. And the other roll that I'm going to do now has a smaller size. And these glue dots are also available in different sizes. So as always, I have the supplies listed in the description box below if you'd like to check those out. And if you already have them in your stash, make sure to go dig them up and give this a try. So I'm going to spread a bunch of those dots around the center word. And I prefer the smaller ones that are on the strips, so you can add them a little bit easier in the spots that where you want them. And now I have a scrap piece of the foil and I'm going to just press that on. And you can press them on a few times, you can rubber on it or use your fingernails, or you could even run it through a die cutting machine, but this gives a bit more of a grungy look, which I like. So I'm just going to do it this way. And this is a very simple way to add some foil accents to your card. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add a bit of transfer gel duo from Deco foil, and I'm going to add that on my card, spreading it like I would butter a sandwich. And make sure you don't pick up too much because it reacts to the oxide ink that was on my card, so you will get some color on your paste as well. So just pick up the amount that you need and not more. And then I'm going to put this card aside to dry. The next thing, I have a tape runner. Tape runners have a nice stickiness, and you can just add them to your card in a random pattern. And this tape is slightly colored, so you can see a bit what pattern I made. And then I'm going to pick some of my foil scraps again. And then I just press the foil on the tape. It's very simple. And again, you can rubber on it, you can use your nails, you can use a brayer, you can use your die cutting machine if you have bigger pieces of scrap. I don't recommend using the die cutting machine when you have a lot of the plastic showing with just a little of the foil still on your scraps, because that will make it stick to your card and then it will be very hard to get it off without tearing like everything off. So then it will look horrible, and unless that's the look you're going for, then I don't recommend that. And I hope you have more foil scraps lying around, and go make some if you haven't, because for this video I've teamed up with Carrie Van Noy and she has more fabulous ways for you to use those scraps, and I will point you in the right direction at the end of this video. And if you miss a spot, you can just add a bit more of the tape. And when you find with tape, and also with double-sided adhesive tape as well, it can stay a little bit sticky, which is annoying. And you can easily fix that with an anti-static pouch. Just go over it and then dust off the rest, and the stickiness is gone. And then the next idea to use those foil scraps, I have some flake and glitter glue. So I add some of that glue to my kitchen paper, and then I'm just going to start pouncing on the card, making a bit of a pattern in the middle to add some stickiness there. And I like reusing tools whenever possible, but this glue stays really sticky and it's very hard to get out of a sponge or a similar tool, which would also work to apply it, but you can't clean it very well, so that's why I chose a piece of kitchen paper. And then I'm going to put that aside to dry. This won't take very long. In the meantime, I'm going to work on a little art journal page, and on the art journal page is some Joggles rice paper, and I'm going to add some lines to some of those shapes with the flake and glitter glue, just adding some simple accents. And the small tip of the glue bottle makes it very easy to apply fine lines and small details. and to work very precise as well. And then I'm going to put this one aside to dry as well. And next I have a card with a foil pattern on it already. And I'm going to add some tape along the edges. And on this card I'm making a sort of a border with tape. But you can also use the tape to make a fun pattern on your card as well, of course. Because tape makes perfect and simple instant stripes. I peeled off the backing pieces. And then I'm going to press on some foil from another scrap piece. And in case you are wondering how you can finish your backgrounds, you can always take a dive into the treasure trunk, where you can find all of Gerry's gems, with lots of words, sentiments, quotes, circles, and so on. All freebies, so make sure to go check those out if you haven't already. And of course you can find the link to the treasure trunk in the description box as well. And once I have all the foil in place, then I press on it here and there to fill the gaps if needed. And you can use the anti-static pouch on this one as well. Next I have the card with the flake and glitter glue again. It's still tacky, but it doesn't come off anymore. So I'm going to grab a bunch of foil scraps again. And when you have a foil scrap where a lot of the plastic is showing already, don't press it down too hard. Because this will make it harder to take it off. As well as you can rip your paper if you press it on too hard. And when you find it a bit harder to take off that foil scrap, then wiggle it instead of ripping it. Because when you rip it, then you will take off most of the stickiness with the foil and the paper together. So just wiggle and be gentle and relaxed and take your time to take it off when it's sticking a bit too much. So a lot of that pattern came off really nicely. And now I'm going to fill those gaps with another color. And this will create another fun background with a bit of a grungy look. And then I have the art journal page. And I'm going to use another scrap piece on that as well. And you can see you get some really cool accents this way, which makes a great contrast with the matte look of the rice paper. And then just check with your fingers if you covered everything. And this gives a really cool result. And then next is the one with the transfer gel duo. And I think I should have left it to dry a little bit longer, as a piece of that plastic where there was no foil on it is sticking to the paste and ripping the paper a bit. But I will show you a way to fix that, which can also be very helpful, hopefully. So I'm just going to fill it with another color now. Just press it on and rub over it with your fingers and then take the foil off again. And then next I thought I'm going to add another color on top and I'm going to run that through my die cutting machine. And then it seemed that there were a lot of spots that I missed. So this color is now the main color, which I didn't plan, but that doesn't matter because I'm going to fix those holes and I'm going to show you how you can add some accents on this one as well. So I'm just adding some of that glue and then I'm going to let that dry. And then I just repeat with the first two colors, adding some more of those accents again to get a bit more color variation going. And this way the holes are fixed as well. And it just looks like it was supposed to turn out this way from the start. And I think this makes another really cool background. And then lastly, if you want to use a complete background because it turned out so cool, but you do not really like that plastic kind of look, then just add the complete piece to your card with double-sided adhesive and then you can go over it with a texture paste transparent matte to mattify your background to get rid of that plastic look. You just add it with a palette knife or any other tool you like and then spread it over the complete background very thinly. You only need a little bit of this and just spread it over the complete background. And when you tilt the card a little bit, you can already see if you didn't miss a spot. And maybe you like the variation of the look as well, so you can play around with that too. And this is the card after drying. It still has that pretty foil shine, but it's not so plasticky anymore, which I think is really cool as well. Now there you have some ideas to put those foil scraps to use. And now hop on over to Carrie's video for more foil scrap ideas. And you can find it right here, as well as in the description box below this video. And as always, make sure to keep on crafting!